Welcome to Unevolved Gaming. Today we're gonna take a closer look at the Megatherium. The Megatherium is a mammal that somewhat looks like a modern day sloth, only far larger in size. They have hooked claws and a muscular tongue, and move around on their knuckles similar to a Calicotherium. Like most herbivores, they are non-aggressive until provoked. The Megatherium, however, is an omnivore, and prefers to feed on creatures with a chitin exoskeleton, like the Pulmonoscorpus. They can be found in the islands, redwoods, snow biomes and around the mountain east of the volcano. Once killed, a Megatherium can be harvested for raw meat, hide, pelt and sometimes raw prime meat. Survivors can use tranquilizer arrows, darts or shocking tranquilizer darts to knock out the Megatherium. However, keep in mind that because of its large size, the Megatherium has a high torpor and will need more tranks to be knocked unconscious than other creatures. A Megatherium can be picked up by a quetzal and dropped in a taming pen on a location of choice. The Megatherium can also be stopped in its tracks by a large bear trap or a chain bola. The Megatherium, being an omnivore, can be tamed with a wide variety of foods. However, it prefers Megalania kibble, raw mutton, giant bee honey or raw prime meat. Taming a Megatherium on one of these four foods will speed up the taming process significantly compared to other creatures of its size. Only a small amount of narcoberries, narcotics or biotoxin is needed to keep a Megatherium's torpor up while taming. A saddle to ride the Megatherium can be crafted in the smithy when a survivor reaches level 52. You can also make a Megatherium sit down, however keep in mind that in order to ride the Megatherium it must be standing. Pressing the ride trigger on your controller makes the Megatherium use its claw attack. This attack can be used while running and will collect berries and a large amount of fiber from bushes. When hitting a tree with this attack, the Megatherium collects some wood and large amount of thatch. Pressing the left trigger on your controller will make the Megatherium use its slam attack. This attack will collect the same resources, however can only be used when standing still. The Megatherium is a slow swimmer and cannot perform any attacks when in deeper water. Currently, the Megatherium is also unable to harvest fish meat. The Megatherium hardly has any enemies. Only large predators like the Allosaurus and the T-Rex will attack it on sight, with the exception of the Pegomastix, Leech and Megapiranha. This makes the Megatherium a perfect mount to explore the swamps. When fighting creatures with a chitin exoskeleton, the Megatherium will receive 150% boost in damage. When the Megatherium kills one of these creatures, with the exception of the Akinata, it will receive another damage boost of 250% for 120 seconds, that can be used against all creatures. When only fighting creatures with a chitin exoskeleton, both boosts will be active and add up to 375% increase in damage. The Megatherium also collects insane amounts of chitin. You can easily get more than 200 chitin from a single Pulmonoscorpus. When killing leeches, the Megatherium also collects leech blood that can be used as bait on a fishing rod. A Megatherium could also be very useful in caves, however due to its large size, it is unable to enter most caves on the island. In my opinion, the Megatherium can be of great use to collect large amounts of fiber and thatch for medium advanced tribes. Even though the wiki states that the Megatherium is not really a battle mount, its high health and stamina make the Megatherium a mount not to be underestimated. The Megatherium's ability to collect leech blood for fishing and the gathering of insane amounts of chitin can be of great value to make cementing paste for survivors that are unable to raid beaver dams or are not yet able to tame an Akinata. That concludes our spotlight on the Megatherium. Don't forget to comment, leave a like and subscribe for more Ark Spotlights. And we will see you in the next episode where we will take a closer look at the Eutyrrhenus.